Have you ever wanted to make an infographic but you don't have any design skills? Well, don't worry, I'm right there with you. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create eye-catching infographics that you can use to educate and inform your audience. And you won't need any special programs or skills to do it. Hi everybody, my name is Roman Grant and I'm an amateur content creator. I love to help beginners learn the best methods to create great content easily. Hit that subscribe button if you want to see more videos like this, and let's start learning. Infographics have become a necessary tool in business, education, and even entertainment. But unless you're a professional graphic designer, they can be very difficult to create. Luckily, there's an easy way to create infographics online, and that's with the graphics platform called Snappa. It's completely free to use, and they have thousands of templates to choose from and customize. And there are literally millions of royalty-free graphics that you can use to make your infographics look great. So without further delay, let's head over to Snappa and create our customized infographic. Okay, here we are, and the first thing to do is create a free account. With the free account, you'll have access to all the templates and stock images, but you'll only be able to download 3 graphics per month. You can unlock unlimited downloads if you upgrade to the Pro plan. So to make an infographic, I suggest starting out with one of their pre-made templates. Don't worry about the size you start out with because you can change that later. Pick the template that is the closest match for your infographic idea. Once the template is loaded, you'll be in the editing platform. This is the Media and Effects panel where you can search for images or change the elements in your design. You can customize any of the elements on this graphic by selecting them over here. This is a drag and drop editor, so it's easy to move and resize any element on the graphic. If you wanted to change the size of your graphic, you can do that up here, but I'm going to stick with this size for now. You can zoom in and out using the scroll bar at the bottom. The first thing you'll want to change is the heading, so people know what the infographic is about. All style changes to the font can be made in this panel on the left. Then, change all the information so that it matches your topic. I'm cutting and pasting from a Word document to save time. The information that you include in your infographic will determine its value, so it pays to do your research when planning it out. If you find that you don't need all the data points that the template gives you, you have two options. You can either delete the unnecessary data points and then resize the ones that you keep, or you can resize the canvas itself. With both of these options, you'll want to make sure that any resizing you do doesn't throw off the other elements of the infographic. So check for other adjustments that might be necessary. Next, you can change all the icons to match the information they represent. Search for icons by using the search bar up here. You'll want to choose similar looking icons for the whole infographic to maintain congruency. For example, don't choose this type of icon for one data point and then choose this type of icon for another. It will throw your design off and make it look clumsy. Then you want to name your design and make sure to save it so you can access it later. After that, you can download it to use it as you wish. Now, of course, there's a lot more you can do to improve the infographic, like changing the colors, fonts, and background. But this will give you a good understanding of the platform so you can start creating your own infographics right away. Thanks for sticking around to the end of the video. Hit that thumbs up if you found it useful, and tell me in the comments why you want to make infographics. Be sure to check out the rest of my channel for more videos on beginner content creation. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.